In today's video, I'm going to be teaching you how to check out sitemaps to learn a little bit more about your competitors and see whether or not they are still actively updating their websites or if they're potentially leaving their websites dormant for you to start to take over that niche. By the end of this video, you're going to have a better understanding of how to use this sort of more intermediate advanced technique in order to do competitive research before assessing whether or not to enter a particular niche. So the tactic for today is to dig into the sitemaps of other people's websites. In most situations, when you come across a niche site, you are going to be able to access their sitemap. The reason why is because sitemaps are the ways that sites are being able to be read by search engines like Google or Bing. They need to have sitemaps in order to make it easier for these search engines to crawl their websites and understand what these websites are all about. So what we first need to do today is find a niche in which it's interesting to us and we want to potentially learn a little bit more about that particular niche and the people that are running sites on that niche. In our example today, I'm gonna continue from the last video where we learned that the ultimate Frisbee niche is potentially a great place for us to build a website. We started to identify a few competing websites that were informational websites around ultimate Frisbee. So let's go ahead and dig into a few of those websites. All right, so the first website for today is ultimatefrisbeehq.com. The last time that we looked at this website, it was just at a very high level, but essentially this is a website around information covering Ultimate Frisbee. To access their sitemap, most of the time it's going to be /sitemap.xml. So in this situation, I've gone ahead and opened up their sitemap, and what you can tell here is that their sitemap has essentially been somewhat dormant. In fact, if I go ahead and zoom in here, you can see that this website was last modified in 2020. It has been several years since they've updated content on their website. And what I can also do is I can take a look at the post content and see just how old the content actually is. And so the first thing that you want to do as you start to look through a sitemap is, what does it look like at a high level? Are they regularly updating posts, or has it been some period of time since they last updated posts? The reason why you want to ask this question is because if they haven't been creating a lot of new content, then it's probably something in which they let the website die. And at this point, it's your opportunity to enter that niche as a more authoritative source. So in this situation, what you can see as I go ahead and zoom in here, or zoom out rather, so that you can see everything, is that they have a few posts, but for the most part, these posts were all modified on June 4th of 2016. And then as I keep on going back, I can keep on going into their page section. And here you can see that they have a bunch of variety in terms of the last modified dates. But for the most part, what you can see here is that these were last modified around anywhere from 2014 when this website started to 2020 in August or so. And so right off the bat, what you can tell from this is that this is probably not all that maintained as a website. And what this also tells you is that this is an opportunity. This is a big opportunity. And the reason why I say that is because in our last video, we saw how this website was still getting around 4,000 monthly traffic visits just around the long tail keyword phrases that they are still ranking for. So even though this all-time chart has stagnated over time, they're still maintaining some level of traffic despite the age of their content, which tells me that in this space, there hasn't been all that much new content around this particular topic. So when I'm looking at these particular sitemaps, I'm looking for a few key things. The first thing I'm trying to understand is, how much content did it take for this competitor to actually rank for what they're ranking for today? So in this case, we have about 3.5K monthly traffic. And what you can tell is that they have 31 URLs here. And what that means is that there's 31 pages, including some things like the homepage and the contact page. But for the most part, there isn't all that much content on this website. In fact, there's 11 posts. And then there is, in the case of the pages, there's 31. 11 plus 31 is 42. So what that means is that maybe if I were to create 100 posts around Ultimate Frisbee covering these topics a little bit more in depth, or even going directly after some of the ones that are already ranking for this website, that I would be able to overtake this website in due time. So as you go through these sitemaps, there's a few key questions and assumptions that you're going through, such as, are they actively maintaining the website? Is it really easy to overcome their already existing moat? Or is it a space in which maybe they've got thousands of pages, and in this situation, you can't easily overtake them because they literally have their digital moat in which they have thousands of posts already of a head start as opposed to you? In that situation, what you would do if you were to see, for example, in this case, that this actually said 310 URLs as opposed to 31, well, you'd have to make that sort of risk assessment as to whether or not it's worth it for you to enter this niche as opposed to finding another niche where you might be able to come up with something closer to the 31 that you see here. So those are some of the things that I'm trying to figure out as I go through the sitemap. How recent is the content? How much content actually is there? And what is the nature of the content? So as I go through these particular pages, what I can see is that for the most part, these content pieces are probably around 1,000 words or so. And so if I were to guess right off the bat, if there's 31 pages, well, that probably means that maybe there's around 50,000 words all in on this website, 50 to 75,000 words. So that's super doable. That's something in which with a couple grand, or if I were to do it myself and write it all from scratch, I would probably be able to overtake this website. So that's really good signal in terms of the ultimate Frisbee niche. Let's go ahead and take a look at the second example that we had from the last video, which was the UAP.com. So I've gone ahead and accessed their sitemap. And here you can see that it's a little bit harder to parse this out, but what we can also do is we can go ahead and just copy this and we can go ahead and put this into a Google Sheet. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and jump a little bit ahead in the video to when I paste this into a Google Sheet. That way you can get a better sense of how you might manipulate this on Google. All right, so here I've got my Google Sheet and what I'm doing is I'm calling this the UAP. And then I'm just gonna go ahead and paste this. It's not gonna be super pretty how I'm gonna do this, but I'm doing it for the sake of showing you how you might do this yourself. I'm sorting the ranges so that it is in alphabetical order. And what that's going to do is it's going to isolate for me all the mumbo jumbo that I need to remove from this particular side of things. And then what I can do is I can delete that. And then I can go ahead and copy and paste the remaining stuff to the top here. So here you can see that essentially we are left with all the respective pages as opposed to anything else. So in this case, what do we see here? Well, what we see is that in this situation, when we exclude everything here, we actually have about 307 pages. So this is actually a perfect analogous example to the first case with Ultimate Frisbee HQ, because this is the 10X site. This is the site that's doing way more than the first site in terms of content. And what you can also see is you can start to try to understand what is going on in their particular pages. So one thing that's catching my eye is that they have a subfolder around their blog in which they cover a lot of different topics. So I'm trying to go through here and I'm trying to see if there's any ideas that potentially are inspiring to me or potentially catch my eye for content that I would want to either create a better version of or create a more authoritative piece around. So in this situation, you can see there's a lot of how-to content, things like how hard is ultimate conditioning by the numbers, how to get open even if you're not fast in ultimate Frisbee, and things like that. So right off the bat, what I'm learning from this sitemap is that it'd probably be a little bit more competitive than the first example. At the same time though, to really confirm whether or not there's potential in this space, the best way to do so is to go ahead and plug in this domain into SEMrush. So going back into SEMrush, I'm gonna go ahead and search for the UAP.com. You can see in this situation, they really don't do all that well in terms of organic search traffic. In this situation, they have 1.2K in organic search traffic. It's entering all-time highs, but for the most part, they're not really covering a lot of ultimate phrases very well. And if I were to guess, the reason why is because they have most things behind a paywall or some sort of login screen. In this situation, you have to go to this login in order to probably access most of this content. And so this is something in which it's not really easy for Google to actually scrape what is going on in this website. The only things that are really possible is looking at things like this blog or, you know, in general, the free resources page and things like that. So if this website wanted to take over more of the organic search rankings, what they could do is they could come up with a way to either publicly display more of the content that's actually in their sitemap or come up with a way in which they might be able to make the pages crawlable but still require login past a certain point. You'll see that happens a lot on sports websites like theathletic.com or just premium sports websites where you have to pay for the ranking. After doing some research on both of these websites, what I'd probably take away from this is that if I wanted to make a pretty small to medium-sized niche website, I could go right after ultimatefrisbeehq.com. It's probably a really nice niche in which you can make a couple hundred bucks every single month from just the display ads if I were to really take over this space. That said though, the UAP.com has a lot going for it in which what they could do is come up with a creative way to open up more of their content. That way, they could potentially rank more of their pages than what they're ranking for right now. Some key takeaways for you though, use the sitemap to figure out when was the last time things were getting updated, as well as how much content is actually on the website that you're visiting, to assess whether or not it's worth it for you to go after them too. In the case where I wanted to go after the UAP.com, what I have to ask myself is, how long would it take me to get to 300 pages? Is it something in which I could create 30 every single month and I could get up to their standard in 10 months? Or is it something in which it might take a few years in order for me to compete with them? If you got value out of this video, I greatly appreciate when you hit that like button below, subscribe for more content like this, and then check out my video over here where I dig into more in depth how to research your competitors and what's working for them.